Hello students, good morning everyone. So in our previous class we have studied index numbers. So what is an index number? Value, you are going to compare the prices or quantities of different year with some particular year. So that values we are going to express in terms of percentages. So there are different formulas for the index number. Based on the formula, the definition will be available. So there is not any precise definition for the index number, and we have discussed different types of index numbers, and among those index numbers, what is the best index number? So what is the best index number? How do you decide? By using the criteria of the index numbers. So there are four criteria. So whichever index number formula satisfies the maximum number of tests, that is said to be the best index number. So we have seen that Fisher's index number satisfies 3 tests, so that's why that is the maximum number of tests satisfied by an index number formula. So since that Fisher's index number is considered as the ideal index number. Now today we are going to discuss the next topic, that is fixed-based index numbers. So I said we are going to compare the prices of a particular year with the prices or quantities of some base year. So here you have to have 2 years, right? One is current year and the other is the base year. So what is current year? What does current year mean? Current year means in which year you are going to compare the price. Base year means with which year you are going to compare the price. Suppose I am comparing 2015 prices with 2005 prices. So I am comparing 2015 prices with 2005. So this 2005 is called as the base year. This 2015 is called as the current year. So I may compare the different years, that is from 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, like this. So I'm going to compare this 5-year prices or quantities with the one base year, that is 2005. So this base year, whatever the base year we are choosing, so if we are calculating the index numbers by fixing the base year. So here I am comparing different year prices with only single year, that is 2005. So here 2005 is fixed, right? So if you are calculating the index numbers by using the base year which is fixed for all the years. So here from 2015 to 2019, for all these years the base year is fixed, that is 2005. So the index numbers which are calculated by the fixed base method are called the fixed base index numbers. So in fixed base index numbers, for all the different years there will be only one fixed base year, that is called the fixed base index number. So in this method, what is the formula to calculate the fixed base index number, we will be seeing now. So for the fixed base index numbers, the year with which we compare the value is called base year, right? So in this method, the index number for the first year is considered as 100. We will be comparing with the first year prices. So index number for the first year will be 100. And for the remaining fixed base index numbers, the formula is given as fixed base index number is equal to divided by the base year value, divided by the base year value into 100. So by using this formula, we are going to calculate the fixed base index number. So the base year should be normal and should not be too distant from the current year. So here I considered 2003 to 2009. So I took the base year as 2005. So whatever the base year you are considering, that base year should not be too far from the current year. That means I'm calculating 2015 prices, means I cannot go for 1885 or 1780 like that prices, because there are too far the comparisons to be. There will be too much difference only. So obviously, if the years the distance is long, obviously you will be getting the differences. So whatever the base year you are choosing, that should be very normal and should not be very distant from the current year. So now this is the fixed base index number. Now we'll study about the chain base index number. Then we'll see for problem related to both the methods. Chain base index numbers. So fixed base index numbers means we are fixing our base year. So in chain base index number, there will be no fixed base period, but the base period is considered as the preceding year value. So you will have these values, right? 2015, 16, 17, 18, 19, like this. So for this, you will be calculating by using the chain process. For 2016, 2015 will be the base year. For 2017, 2016 will be the base year. So by using the preceding years, we will be calculating the index numbers. We have considered base period with reference to which the comparisons were made, right? That was fixed. But many economists felt that there should be an homogeneity. So, since to maintain the homogeneity, we are considering the previous years as the base years. So, this developed the chain base method of constructing the index numbers. In this method, the present year and the immediately preceding year is taken as the base year. So how to represent this chain base index numbers means, here whatever the first value is there, that is called as the first link. So if I write P01, what does this mean? Comparing the price of the first year compared to the base year. 0 means base year, 1 means current. So this P01 is called as the first link. Whatever the first value you get, that is called as the first link. And the next value, how you will write P02. So how you will get P02? By using the preceding value. P01 into P12. Preceding value into P12, that is the year, the current year value. P2 means 2 is the current year. For that, what is the base year of the preceding year? 1. Similarly, we will be getting the next links also. If I want P03, how you will write? I want P03. What is the previous link of it? P02. Into what is the previous year value? P23. Here we took for P02 means P12, the previous year value. So P03 means the previous value will be P23. So in this way, you are going to calculate the index numbers using the chain base index numbers. So what is the procedure means? For the step 1 is, we have to calculate the link relatives. So what are link relatives means? We have studied the link relative method also. How do we calculate the link relatives? By using the So next step is the chain base index number for the first period is considered as 100. So in the second step we will calculate the chain base index numbers. So the first period, for the first period the value will be 100 as usual, and for the next years how to calculate this chain base index number is denoted with CBI numbers. So current period ella into previous same like the cumulative method only, chain base index number is equals to the formula is LR of the current period. So this is the procedure for calculating the link relatives using the chain base index numbers and calculation of the price index numbers. So single commodity is okay, if there are, don't forget, if there are more than one commodities we will be taking average of those commodities. Now coming to the problem on the fixed base and the chain base index numbers. So here different years and prices corresponding to those different years are given. So there are no more commodities, only single commodity is given. So we need to calculate the fixed and chain base index numbers. So in fixed base, first I have calculated fixed base index number. So here we said the first value will be 100. So whatever the first value here, 1991, is considered as the base year. So I am calculating fixed base index number by considering 1991 as the base year. So next value is how we will calculate. For this year, what is the current value? 240 divided by, what is the fixed price? 200 into 100. You will be getting 150. Similarly, the next one, 150 divided by 200 into 100. You will be getting 75. Similarly, 100 divided by 200 into 100, we will be getting 50. Next, 150 divided by 200 into 100, we will be getting 75. So, similarly, like that, you calculate all the fixed base index number. Next, I have to calculate the chain base index numbers. So, in construction of the chain base index numbers, what is the first step? First, we have to calculate the link relatives. So, first, calculate the link relatives. So how to calculate the link relatives value? Present value divided by previous value into 100. So first link relative will be always 100. So coming to the next values, what is the present value? 240 divided by, what is the previous value? 200 into 100 equals to, we will be getting the same 120. Next is, what is the present value here? 150. So 150 is divided by previous value is 240 into 100 is equals to, what is the value? 150 divided by 240. Divided by 240 into 100, you will be getting 62.5. So similarly like that, you will be calculating all the link relatives. So how to calculate the chain base index numbers? Chain base index numbers. So what is the formula for the chain base index number? You will be considering LR of present answer as 75. So similarly, calculate all the remaining values. So these are the answers for this problem. So in column 3, we have all the fixed base index number, where 1991 is considered as a fixed base index number, and these are all the chain base index numbers, that is 100, 120, 75, 50, 75, 100, 125, and 150. Next, we will see the second problem. Now, coming to the next question, calculate the chain base index numbers. Here, if you observe, well, see, the different commodities are given, that is A, B, C, and the prices in the different years are. So, how to calculate? We will see the solution now. First, we have to calculate the link relatives, right? So, as it is, calculate the link relatives. First, write down the commodities. Next, years.
Chain base index number, the first value will be
So this is about chain base and the fixed base index numbers. So these in chain base fixed base indices are very simple to construct, whereas the chain base are little bit difficult. Now we'll see the next topic. Now our next topic is cost of living index numbers. So cost of living index numbers are also called as the consumer price index number. So what is cost of living? Cost of living means what is the cost of living of our present year. So compared to the previous years, is there any change in the cost of living of any class of the people as compared with the base year? Is called as the cost of living index number. Index number means we are comparing the prices, right? So we are comparing prices with reference to the cost of living. That means a family, a class of family is maintaining the same standard of living as compared to the base year. Suppose in 2010, how I was living? I was getting some income. Is that my cost of living is sufficient? With this 2020 or not, the same maintenance we are doing or not can be studied by using the cost of living index numbers. That means it is an average increase in the cost of maintaining the same standard. So how to maintain the same standard? So the average increase, how much increase is there in the cost of maintaining the same standard as compared to the base year is called the cost of living index number. So maintaining same standard means it totally depends on the price, right? So price is the only factor considered for calculating the cost of living index number. But there are some other factors also which influences the standard of living. That it may be either the size of the family. So the income, the prices may be same. But if there are many people in the family, suppose 4 to 5 people, means we can adjust our income with the later prices. But the size of the family is big, or there are any other health issues, any kind of other problems. So all that also affects the cost of living. But price is considered as the major factor. So what are the different steps in construction of index number? We will see now. So the main steps involved is the scope and coverage, first one, and the family budget inquiry. Scope and coverage and the family budget inquiry. Coming to scope and budget. So the first step is specify the particular population group or the class for which index numbers is calculated. So first, why we are calculating these index numbers? So for calculating these index numbers, what is the class of the family we have to choose? On which families we are going to conduct this survey should be known. That comes under the scope and coverage. So industrial workers or the government employees or the low income, middle income. So there will be different classes in the society, right? So the class should be selected first, and the next is family budget inquiry. So after deciding about the class, we will have a family budget inquiry. So we will inquire that family that how much they are spending, and we conduct a survey on those families. That is, we select a sample of the families from each class and the people for which the index numbers are intended. So these are the two main steps for the construction of the involved in the construction of the cost of living index number. Now next is also we will be selecting the commodities. After family budget, we will also select the commodities. The third step is commodities. What are the different commodities used by those classes will be considered here. And the next is the different prices of those commodities. So that is the retail prices. expenditure method. The formula for calculating the consumer price index number using the aggregate expenditure method is given as P01 equals to summation of P1Q0 by summation P0Q0 into 100. So this is the formula for the average expenditure method for calculating the cost of living index number. So what is P1? P1 is the price in the current year, Q0 is the quantity in the base year, and P0 is the quantity price in the base year. Now coming to the family budget method. So the formula under family budget method is given as P01 equals to summation IW by summation W. So what does it I mean? I is the price relative. So this price relative I is given as I equals to P1 by P0 into 100. So price relative means the P1, that is the current year price divided by previous year price into 100. And what is W? W is the weight we know, right? So W is the weight or the value which is given as W equals to P0 Q0. So hence the formula will become, so if you substitute I and W values, what is the formula we get? P01 is equals to summation, what is the I value? P1 by P0 into 100, summation of P1 by P0 into 100 into W value is P0 Q0. So if P0 and P0 gets cancelled, you will be getting summation. So sorry, in the denominator, summation P0 Q0. So hence P01 is equals to P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into 100. So if you observe either it is a average expenditure method or the family budget method, the formula is precise as same. Here we are assigning the weights. So the formula is same, but on simplification we will get the same aggregate expenditure method. So you may be using any method, but the formula answer will be same.